So let me tell you about my favorite methods of all, called Graph Slam. This is one of many methods for Slam, and this is the one that's by far the easiest to explain. Let's assume we have a robot, and let's call arbitrarily the initial location x equals 0 and y equals 0. For this example, we just assume the robot has a perfect compass and we don't care about heading direction, just to keep things simple. And let's assume the robot moves to the right in x direction by 10. So it's now over here. In a perfect world, you would know that x1, the location after motion, is the same as x0 plus 10, and y1 is the same as y0. But we learned from our various robotic common filter lessons and others that the location is actually uncertain. So rather than assuming in our xy coordinate system the robot moved to the right by 10 exactly, we know that the actual location is a Gaussian centered around 10, 0, but it's possible the robot is somewhere else. Remember we worked out the math for this Gaussian? Here's how it looks like, just for the x variable. Rather than setting x1 to x0 plus 10, we try to express a Gaussian that peaks when these two things are the same. So if you subtract from x1, x0 and 10, put this into a square format and turn this into a Gaussian, we get a probability distribution that relates x1 and x0. We can do the same for y, and since there's no change in y according to our motion, all we ask is that y1 and y0 are as close together as possible. The product of these two Gaussians is now our constraint. We wish to maximize the likelihood of the position x1 given that the position x0 is 0, 0. So what Graph Slam does is defining our probabilities using a sequence of such constraints. Say we have a robot that moves in some space, and each location is now characterized by a vector x0 and a vector x1, vector x2, vector x3. Often they're three-dimensional vectors. Then what Graph Slam collects is the initial location, which is a 0, 0, 0 usually, although here it looks a little bit different. And then, really importantly, lots of relative constraints that relate each robot pose to the previous robot pose. We call them relative motion constraints. You can think of those as rubber bands. In expectation, this rubber band will be exactly the motion the robot sensed or commanded. But in reality, it might have to bend it a little bit to make the map more consistent. And speaking about maps, let's use landmarks as an example. So suppose there's a landmark out here, and the landmark is being seen from the robot with some relative measurement. 0, z1. Perhaps it didn't even see it during time 2, but then this is z3. All these are also relative constraints, very much like the ones before. Again, they're captured by Gaussians, and we get relative measurement constraints. One such constraint every time the robot sees a landmark. So Graph Slam collects those constraints, and as we'll see, they're insanely easy to collect. And it just relaxes the set of rubber bands to find the most likely configuration of robot path along with the location of landmarks. And that is the mapping process. Let me ask you a quick quiz. It'll take some thinking. Suppose we have 6 robot poses. That is 1 initial and 5 motions. And we have 8 measurements of landmarks that we've seen. These might be multiple landmarks. Sometimes a robot saw more than one. The question now is, how many total constraints do we have if we count each of these constraints for exactly 1 constraint?